Then Gardener's World presenter Mark Lane joins us in the studio. Your first time here. We're surrounded by plants, Mark. What do you think?
It's amazing, isn't it? It's like we're in a forest. No, it's actually...
Don't get carried away. It's not quite a forest, Mark, but thank you.
It's really homely, isn't it? It's because we just want to kick back and have a natter.
I think they've done it to make us feel productive, and I feel like it's working. And that's actually something that plants can do for us, isn't it?
Absolutely. Plants, they can make us productive. They can make us concentrate more. If you take this wonderful Swiss cheese plant here, for example, big green leaves. By looking at those green leaves 10 minutes of a day, you will improve your productivity and you will increase your output.
Why haven't we gotten any? We need some of these in there.
I know. Tell me about it. You do. You need these. And then we've got the wonderful peace lily. This wonderful peace lily. This is incredible because this actually will take all those nasty sort of dust particles and anything. If you've got like breathing problems, takes all of that way into the leaves. It takes it down to the roots and uses it as food. And then all it does, it then gives out wonderful clean oxygen for clean air.
And is it right they can also help with stress as well?
Yeah, they really can. I mean, for example, you know, if you're worried about the air quality and you're worried about dry skin, something like the good old spider plant, if they put that into a room, within 2 days, it will clean the air by 90%. So therefore, you're going to reduce your sort of your anxiety and your stress levels. And it's also going to calm you down just by looking at it. Your cortisol and your dopamine will start to sort of increase, decrease. Exactly. Stare at that plant. Just keep staring at it, Gavin.
It's working.
And you will feel wonders. It's just, I mean, just take good old chamomile, for example. We all know that good old chamomile before bed makes you want to sleep. But there's a particular amino acid. And what it does, when you drink it, there's an amino acid inside of you called glycine. And that actually relaxes your muscles and therefore makes you more relaxed and a bit sleepy.
Is there a link between the type of plant that you have at home and your personality? I've read studies about this, but is it true?
Yeah, of course it is.
I mean, in what way? How does it work?
Well, if you look at a plant or you look at anyone's garden, for example, it's a real reflection of that individual's personality. Mm. But also, what you grow, I think, can really show a lot about you and also just sort of gives a little bit of a tease about what your personality is like.
So I Gethin's is full of weeds.
what would my plant be?
Well, thinking about this, I think you were voted, hottie? By a certain magazine.
Let's go with that.
Also because of your sort of love of rugby, I would probably go for something like aloe vera. So aloe vera is obviously from a hot climate, but at the same time, it's been used in sport. It's good for the skin, but also helps with dehydration.
Okay.
What about me? I'm cool, I'm scared now.
Well, for you, no, with you, I think, no, hopefully I got this right. You like Marilyn Monroe? So I have gone for Amaryllis Marilyn, and it's this beautiful, big, white, fluffy amaryllis. And it's brilliant, obviously, at this time of the year. It's a lovely seasonal bulb. And if you can put it into a corner, just leave it there and it will flower its socks off.
Mine's prettier than yours.
First thing I'm going to do is buy an aloe vera plant. But I'm actually quite rubbish at looking after plants at home. Are there plants that are good for people like me that you want, everything you say, you want the greenery around you, but you might not be the best at looking after them?
Yeah, well, cacti and succulents are really good because obviously they don't need a lot of water. But what we've actually got on the table are just perfect examples. So the peace lily is really easy. The spider plant, you know, everyone grew them, especially in the 1970s, and they're growing all the way now. They'll have little offsets, you can grow them on as well. But all of these will be perfectly, and the good way of testing, if your plants need a water, stick your finger in.
Get the finger
exactly,
in.
Exactly, down to two knuckles. If it's dry, water them. If it's still moist, don't.
Love that. Thank you so much, Mark.
Brilliant. You're welcome.
Brilliant stuff. Yeah. Now then, tonight, after a long 3 months of off our tellies, Holby City is back with a bang on BBC One at 8.